and it's really a poor performance overall.
I'm going to call Mojo Mathis. Mojo Mathis.
I think at the heart of what we're discussing here is what kind of New Zealand do we want? One that is compassionate and caring and supports people on the way to having a decent standard of living and to support themselves and their family, or one that is harsh and judgmental on people who are experiencing tough times, harsh and judgmental on disabled people. And this is an issue that's really close to my heart. Recent statistics that have been released on cold, damp housing says that 38% of disabled people cannot keep their houses warm, significantly higher than any other group. This is because, you know, just think about that. People with disability are living in cold, damp housing, 38% of people with disability. The very people who often, for health reasons, need to be kept warm, need to be in warm housing, are not. The social support system in New Zealand is failing these people. Year in, year out, winter after winter, they're living in cold, damp housing. They're living in cold, damp housing because the benefits are not enough to secure rental housing that is warm and dry for them. And because not only is the rent too high, but for many people, there's a shortage of accessible housing, housing that meets their needs. So they are forced, both because of their specific needs and because of low income, to accept the worst possible housing sometimes. And that is just outrageous. This is not what we want for New Zealand. And the other issue I want to pick up on is the one that was raised by my colleague, Jan Logie, about the culture of women being intimidating. About this woman, a solo woman with a baby, who could not get the benefit because she was so intimidated by going into rooms. Well, I know what that feels like because I've been there. I've been there under two different governments. I've directly experienced what it feels like to go to rooms under a government that's harsh and judgmental, that has a rant on about beneficiary bloodshed. Do you remember these days? Well, I remember trying to go to Windsor and asking for the unemployment benefit. It was like being hauled over the coals just while I could get the unemployment benefit to see me through a few months. It was an incredibly humiliating experience, and that was under a national government. So what happened? Jumped forward 15 years later, and a Labour government was in. I thought that the culture at Wind might still be the same. So one, there was a crisis in the family business and there was no money coming in for several months and the cupboards were bare. I still could not bear to go to Wynn, but I was terrified of being subjected to the same treatment. Finally, a friend rang Wynn and said, look, you know, I have this mum with three children who is actually quite desperate for a food grant. This was under a Labour government and they said, come on in, just bring in your records for your business and we'll see what we can do for you. The atmosphere was completely different. This was, and I cannot tell you how important that is, just that fundamental culture of respect when somebody walks in that door and says we're experiencing tough times. They should not have to dot every I and cross every T and produce a billion swathes of documents to show who they are multiple times over. They shouldn't have to prove that they have a disability every 6 months or every year or whatever it is. That's what happens at Wind. It's so intimidating, so overwhelming that people are desperate when they try and explain. And then they get it wrong. Sometimes they get it wrong. They confess they've earned some money that week. That they got it wrong and they cut off their benefit by 50% that for straight away without actually factoring in that, hey, over time, they haven't earned that much. There are so many things wrong at the moment in Wind. So many things. And the only way we're going to get things better to change that culture, and that is going to require changing the government, because I cannot see National ever recognising that they have such a serious problem with the culture of bringing. Thank you.
I call Chris Hopkins.
Thank you very much, Mr.